on a 71-yard drive. Slaton lost a couple of yards on the ground in that drive, and McAfee boots it to Robinson. Can he produce another big return? Kind of bumped into a blocker, circles back, and it'll get swallowed up at the 15. John Holmes, the DB there on the coverage. So
tonight, this is one of the worst fields I've seen, so this is a throwback for him. His linemen have cooperated with the conditions on the field and held their own, playing very well.
Get the feeling there's a lot of urgency for every possession for the Panthers because their defense is in for a long night. And Stevens howling stopped. It was a very promising opening.
Hey, Pat White. I just hope people are taking this in. 5 of 6. And the way he has thrown the football tonight, a little variety to Steve Slaton.
Yeah, Rodriguez said not many wrinkles in a short week. We've seen a couple tonight, though, using Slaton much more as a receiver. Harris.
Water. The guys before the game said their feet were sticking to the ground. They weren't slipping. But that field in the middle, guys, is looking pretty messy. Guys are starting to change their cleats.
Yeah, they better. This is not one of the prettier fields you'll find in the NFL. Frequent complaints from the Steelers play here. On third down, nice completion. Oderick Turner, who breaks free. Oderick Turner.
Defense from the Louisville game where they struggled is tackling better in space. And that time, Larry Williams allows the ball to be caught, but you got to make the tackle.
Good. I think 5 different guys started corner this year. It's been a trouble spot. Stevens howling on the delay, has room up the middle. Cuts back.
He's so small, he doesn't need a big crease to get through.
So 59 yards in the last 2 plays after the Panthers faced a 3rd and long. Falco, just a few seconds left. Has protection, now has to duck down. Good coverage job there by the Mountaineers. Falco angry, wanted his receiver to kind of release. Holmes, the safety combining with Wicks on the stop. Seen good offensive fireworks in the early going here. West Virginia touchdowns on each of their first 2 possessions. Panthers got up to a 7-0 lead, now trying to tie the score, salvage their season after 3 straight losses. The Mountaineers still in great position to win the Big East. Falco flips it across to Marcel Pastano. He's thrown out of bounds at the 15, thrown down hard after a gain of about 7 by John Holmes. Almost a backwards pass there.
Almost a backwards pass, but what I noticed there, Pastano picks up good yardage, but when Holmes came over to knock him out of bounds, he threw him out of bounds and then came up and had a few words for him. He's fortunate there. He didn't pick up 15 yards, or in this case, half the distance to the goal line, and an automatic first down.
Rodriguez would have blown a gasket if that happened. 3rd and 5. Falco throws to the end zone, wide open.
It's not only a mess, but it's uneven. That's the toughest part about the field.
Vaughn Rivers, a running start as he spins across the 20 and then gets smacked down there. So Mountaineers 2 for 2, reaching the end zone. We'll go back on offense as we check in. All right, Reese, thanks. About 18 and a half minutes. We've had 4 touchdown drives of 70 yards or longer. White flips it back to Brandon Miles, who gets a couple of nice blocks. Muscles out to the 35 for a first down. Slaton was out there blocking, doing a bit of everything.
Well, they've been moving Steve Slaton around. He's in the slot that time and gets the ball to Miles. But Pat White right now, again, showing that he has the ability to throw the football. He's mixed it up. He's thrown quite a bit, actually, to his tailback, but reminding people that if you take away the throw, he can run, but he goes back. And that's hitting Steve Slaton right in stride. He's 6 of 7 right now for 105 yards, looking very, very in control of this game.
He's rushed for 45. Slaton corralled and dropped for a loss. Blades was there to help out Corey Davis, the sophomore from Pittsburgh. Defensive line, not the strength of this defense. They're just kind of trying to hold guys up and let the linebackers come make the plays.
Well, they told us that the front 4 and the middle linebacker have to take away the running game of Steve Slaton and leave it up to the perimeter players to slow down Pat White. And that was textbook that time on how to slow down Steve Slaton.
Now a pitch. And Reyna takes it from White on the sidelines. The wrinkles just keep coming. And Pitt's defense has done a pretty good job tonight. A lot of negative rushing plays by the Mountaineers, Kirk. But then all of a sudden, the explosion and the quick game.
I love this one. This is a nice little wrinkle where he's got Raynon way back here lined up as a wide receiver. But after the fake to Slaton, everybody collapses down. Now he's coming out to the outside. I know the play wasn't real successful, but he had a receiver in the slot who just kind of waited to be in position to be in pitch relationship with his quarterback.
And sets up a third and four. White, a little dart to a man wide open, and it's Raynon fighting inside the 35 before Sam Bryant brings him down. The accurate throws continue. White limping a little bit as he moves across midfield.
The passing continues, and a lot of it, again, right towards Sam Bryant, the safety. And if you have a safety who's responsible in one-on-one coverage with a gifted receiver like Raynon, who's really a tailback lined up as a slot receiver, that is an easy throw for a guy like Pat White to make.
See if the Panthers can make some adjustments, get Bryant some help. Slaton. And again, a good job by H.B. Blades doing his job, flying through there. The senior comes from Plantation, Florida, the great Blades family name. His father, Benny, with whom he shares his full name, Horatio Benedict Blades. This guy grew up around good football. His uncle Al, instrumental in raising him, another former Hurricane in Miami. What a player this guy is. Thought he deserved to be a Butkus finalist. Missed out narrowly at making the top three.
One of the great warriors this year in college football. Plays with a great deal of passion. He missed this game last year.
They give it off to Schmidt, the fullback again, who's ailing a little bit with an ankle problem in his short game. Talked about Benny Blades. Football player. The look Spielman has in his eye a lot of the time. Still perfect on third down coming into this pass attempt, and there's the first miss on third down. Reynon well covered over there by Kennard Cox. It's Brandon Miles, check it, the intended receiver.
Because Miles was set up so far to the top of your screen, he was about 5 yards from the boundary. He didn't have a lot of room to work with that time against Cox. The ball was actually thrown to the inside, but Cox nonetheless had great coverage on Miles.
So here comes Pat McAfee, 51 yards, his longest attempt of the season. Tough stadium for kickers. Trying to draw it back in, and he just snuck it in there. And the kicker is even chest bumping over West Virginia. This has a reputation of being a very tough place to kick. And when you get one in Heinz Field for 51, you've done something. I mean, that's a nice little draw squeezed inside the post. Mountaineers up by three. And the Panthers will try to answer. McAfee, fresh off that long field goal, makes the mistake and puts the ball out of bounds and is mad at himself.
Well, he was on a roll there, and only to have a poor kickoff. But Tyler Palco comes back out of the field, and we've been talking so much tonight about he and Pat White, and both have lived up to our expectations and maybe a little bit more. And don't count Tyler Palco out in this game. He has a heart of a lion, heart of a champion. He will get his team back in there. He's a coach's son. He has that kind of mindset. Always over at the facility. They have to kick him out at 10:30 at night, say, hey, man, it's enough for one day. Get out of here and come back tomorrow. He just loves to grind and work at getting better.
Pitches it out there to Derek Kidner. 63 career touchdown passes, Kirk. He's tracking a couple of guys named Moreno and Alex Van Pelt, who is super productive here, a four-year quarterback for the Panthers, and all of the career records.
He doesn't have ideal size for the NFL. He's about 6'1 and a half or 6'2. But I think his game experience that he's received at Pitt, and the fact that he's played in Walt Harris's system and now Matt Kavanaugh's system, who's from the NFL, I think it's going to allow him to transition with less of a learning curve than some of the other quarterbacks in college football.
Stevens howling. in on the toss sweep, trying to pick his way through traffic. Stop at the 40 by Eric Wickson. Larry Williams.
Telling you what they tell me.
You got double the players in the college team and an NFL team.
I guess, you know, the Steelers feel that maybe they deserve a little bit more room.
Relax. Third down complete. First down. Still trying to spin free as Kinder.
Considering that, you know, Minnesota and the Vikings, you know, Glenn Mason's been asking for his own facility for a long time.
Are they going to get it? Over there.
I know. Finally.
Conridge Collins, the fullback. Got a nice little.
Usually you see the big guys stay in and the tailback go out. That time they reverse roles and it's a great game for the Panthers.
Falco still has it. Fights off Wicks and.
Backfield, he's a total package.
So the loss by Falco sets up second and long. He flips it off once again, looking for Collins. This time he's pretty well covered, but you can see the strength as Boo McClee has to wrestle into the ground. For our, we asked the question about NFL and college team sharing stadiums. Ready for an Affleck trivia question? Those of you that follow this rivalry, maybe Bino is ineligible, but he would certainly know about this. The highest scoring game in backyard brawl history. Get your ESPN encyclopedia. You can phone to page 716 for the answer, but that would be cheating. Third and seven. Panthers 5 of 6 on third down so far. Play action. He's got room. Flips it into open territory. Finally, just had a cut bait. Wonsett furious. He thought Falco was hit on the sidelines there. Doesn't get a flag. Morty Ivy, the backup linebacker in coverage. Wonsett went to 15.
Did a little shove there. It's getting chippy too, by the way. And Tyler Falco, the last couple plays, has been involved in some activity. The play before, you see James Ingram in the background hit him, and then he gets.
That's good strength out of the quarterback.
I was going to say,
huh?
He gets stoned by Tyler Falco. It's the backyard brawl, baby. When the
open end of Heinz Field. High snap. Low kick, and he drives it.
First half, but at least they're scoring with West Virginia.
Russell, the putter, kicks off, and it's a high one taken by Vaughn Rivers. Rivers shows a burst of speed and gets out near the 30. Under Armour, rally to win it late over West Virginia. Falco, four clutch third down completions and a touchdown run. This is White now turning it up. He's about five. Falco is one of the high points of his career. It's White. He's still got it, and he's got a man wide open who dropped it. Darius Reynard a little bit behind him at the 45, but should have had it. Rodriguez got what he was looking for.
This is what happens if you get so excited about defending the run. Watch everybody and what they do when action comes this way. The only one to stay was HB Blades, but look behind HB Blades. If Reynard makes that catch in the open field, Shane Murray would struggle to make that play.
Turn and look downfield before he gathered the football. So now it's third and five. It's complete, but a loss on the play. First punt for the Mountaineers. They use that rugby punt on the run. It's tricky. And fielding it is Darrell Revis. Trying to get a block, and he gets a huge one. Revis down the sidelines. One man to beat. The punter able to slow him up, but he's still spinning into the end zone. Seen the big kickoff return from Robinson, and now the touchdown by Revis. This is Vaughn Rivers trying to answer for the Mountaineers, but that coverage is pretty solid. And now we'll see how the Mountaineers respond. Punt. But they might be looking to shelve that. So White back to work, down seven. Fights forward for four. Halftime, a minute 35 away. Let's check in with Reese.
Still can't believe he stayed in bounds.
They're going to keep it on the ground again, but again, you can create a big play with this kind of an offense. Duncan on the stop.
I tell you, this defensive line, the end zone, shocker.
White throw, there's a man wide open. It's Slaton. He doesn't lose foot races. What a first half. Just when you think the Panthers have momentum, White, another perfect throw.
It goes back to how they've moved him around. This time he's in the backfield. Tommy Campbell's one of the fastest players on the Pitt defense. He's been manned up. This is the second time he got isolated, Chris. And when Pat White has time to throw and Steve Slaton is one-on-one with a linebacker, that's not fair. And how about the throw by Mr. Pat White?
They kind of lulled him to sleep, though. A couple of runs, Kirk. You thought maybe Rodriguez was going to be content to go to the locker room down seven. They get the ball to start the third quarter. He gets a miss.
And there was Mark and I breaking down Ohio State, Michigan. We'll get to that later. But it's great job by HB Blades telling Tommy Campbell, keep your head up. Keep your head up. That's a senior taking care of a sophomore, but isolated one-on-one. Now it's Paul Rhodes trying to keep his head up. They say he's got great speed, but one-on-one, this is a matchup that Pat White will take every time. And I don't care who's covering Steve Slaton, but how about the throw right over the shoulder again to number 10 for the touchdown?
And Slaton, you figure there's no way. If you're a defense, you hold him to 7 yards rushing at a half. There's no way you can get beat, getting hurt. He's caught the ball for 130 yards receiving. Did have the 15-yard touchdown run, but he's been dropped for a loss numerous times. As Slaton is a guy that's going to have wrist surgery after the season. There's still some concern about that funny bone problem he had against Louisville.
Well, I think tonight's a great example, this first half, about people that have questioned West Virginia. And, well, all they do is run the football. What would happen if teams continue to challenge them and try to take that part of their game away? First half, they've run for 67 and thrown for 201 yards. So, again, they're showing that they have that versatility.
Another short kickoff. And it's T.J. Porter and Doran Dickerson, I should say. He's got it.
By the way, that's one way to take the air out of the stadium after a big turn of events on that big return, is to have a big play by one of your go-to guys in Steve Slaton.
With the rain starting now.
Chris, here he is, matched up one-on-one. How many times do we see Matt Leinart do this with Reggie Bush? That's backyard football. little wheel route, down and up, tough to stay with him.
Is going to throw. He's going to look downfield. Why not? Man wide open. It's Kinder into the open field.
And Palko found him in a seam. What's West Virginia's defense thinking there?
They wind the clock. Palko flips it over the middle. Caught again. And Pittsburgh now again. No timeouts. It's Kinder in motion. They flip it short. Angle shot for Connor Lee from 40 yards. Now he's kicked. Low line drive kick through the end zone. And that'll be the final play of a very exciting first half here at Heinz Field. Momentum back and forth. Punts run back for a touchdown. Big blocks. And the folks here looking forward to the second half, as is Dave Wonstedt, as with Aaron.